session on mathematical logic. In this session, we shall solve some problems. So, the first question, write the verbal form of the following compound propositions given. So, you have to write the verbal form of these compound propositions. Simple propositions are given, P, Q, R are given. So, P is X is a real number, Q is mathematics is easy, R is today is a holiday. So, we need to form these compound propositions. So, let us begin with the first one. First one is P or Q. So, this symbol is for or. So, we need to write P or Q, verbal form. Verbal form means how you say it. So, what is P? X is a real number. So, X is a real number connected with the or. Q, mathematics is easy, or mathematics is easy. So, second one, negation of P and R. So, you need to negate P. What is the negation of P? P is X is a real number. So, what is its negation? X is not a real number. That is its negation. So, negation means you have to insert the word not appropriately. So, negation of P is X is not a real number. So, negation P, X is not a real number. Then you have and. So, write and. R, what is R? Today is a holiday. And today is a holiday. Okay. So, the third one. P or R implies Q. Okay. So, this is a conditional. So, conditional or implication we call it. So, P or R implies Q. So, when you have a single arrow, it is if, then. So, you have to start with if. Whenever there is a single arrow, your statement should start with if. So, if, now start this, P or R. So, P is X is a real number. So, if X is a real number or R. So, or today is a holiday, or today is a holiday, so this much is over, then comes the arrow, so you have to write then, so it is if then, so if X is a real number, or today is a holiday, then Q, Q is mathematics is easy. Then mathematics is easy. Then mathematics is easy. So, this is an implication statement, if then. So, if X is a real number or today is a holiday, then mathematics is easy. So, the last one, that is P biconditional Q or R. So, how do we write this? So, P, P is X is a real number. X is a real number. Then you have double sided arrow, which means if and only if. X is a real number. If and only if. Q. What is Q? Mathematics is easy. If and only if mathematics is easy. Or R. Today is a holiday. Or today is a holiday. So this is how you write the verbal form. Second question, symbolize the following propositions. So now the compound propositions are given, you need to write its symbol. Whereas in the first question, symbols were given, you have written it in the verbal form. Now it is verbal form, you have to convert it to symbols. So read the first one. 3x is equal to 9 and x is less than 7. So these two simple propositions are connected with the word and. Okay, so and is the logical connective. So how do you write this? So this is P, so this is P, this part is Q. So P and Q is connected with the connective and. So the symbolization of this is P and Q. P and Q. Coming to the second one, 33 divided by 11 is not equal to 3, or 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. There are two logical connectives in this proposition, that is not, okay, not equal to 3. So the not, that is one of the logical connectives, and then you have or. So how do you write this? So in this proposition, P is 33 divided by 11 is equal to 3, and Q is 8 minus 6 is equal to 2. Okay, so this is P, this is Q. So how do you symbolize this? Here you have not equal to, so negation P or Q. So this is how you symbolize this. It is, see here, 33 divided by 11 equal to 3. Here it is not equal. So it is negation of P or Q as it is. So negation P or Q. Third one, if oxygen is a gas, then gold is a compound. So you have if, then. So if, then is the logical connective here. Oxygen is a gas, this is P. Gold is a compound, this is Q. So how do you symbolize this? It is P conditional Q. Okay, so if P, then Q. This is the way to symbolize. Coming to the fourth one, Y plus 4 not equal to 4, or E is not a vowel. So here also you have not, here also you have not, and then you have or. So how do you write this? It is a negation P or negation Q. So Y plus 4 is equal to 4 is P. E is a vowel, that is Q. So E is not a vowel is negation Q. Y plus 4 not equal to 4 is negation P. So negation P or negation Q. This is how you symbolize. Third question. If P, Q and R are propositions with the truth values false, true and true respectively, then find the truth values of the following compound propositions. So P is having the truth value false, Q is having true and R is having false. So with that we need to find the truth value of this compound proposition. Now before I solve this problem, I want you to recall the truth tables of all the five logical connectives. Okay, so let me help you recall. We have and, okay, and. When is and true? What do you have to remember in and? You have to remember that if both the propositions, simple propositions are true, then the resultant is true. Remaining all cases, it is false. Coming to or, if both are false, then it is false. If both are false, then it is false. Remaining all cases, it is true. Negation is easy. If it is true, then negation will be false. If the proposition is false, negation will be true. Coming to implication, that is your if then, what you have to remember is, first one is true, second one is false, will give you the answer false. Remaining all cases, it is true. Coming to double implication, that is your biconditional. If both are true, the answer is true. If both are false, the answer is true. Remaining two cases, it is false. Okay? So both true, true, both false, true. Okay? So you need to remember that much, so that will help you solve many of your problems. So first one, you have negation P implies Q or R. So negation P, so let me write as it is. No, when you solve, just write down negation. What is the truth value of P? P is false. So write false. Implies Q. Q is true. Or R. R is again false. Okay. Now, negation of false. Negation of false is true. True implies true or false. Now, true implies true. See your conditional. In your conditional, it is false only if first one is true and second one is false. Remaining all cases, it is true. So true implies true is true itself or false. Look at your or. Or is false only if both are false. Otherwise, it is true. So here you will get true. So the answer for this, the truth value of this compound proposition is true. Okay? So similarly, we shall work out the second one. Negation, P is false, implies Q is true. Or negation, P is false if and only if, that is biconditional, Q is true. Okay, so negation keep as it is. Under conditional, if then, false and true. So see here, true false means false. So false true will be true. All the other cases will be true. Or negation. Under if and only if, false true. So under if and only if both are true, true. Both false, true. Remaining cases is false. So this comes under those remaining cases. So it is false. Now negation of true is false or negation of false is true. Now it is connected with the symbol or. So or is false if both are false. In this case it is true. So the answer, that is the truth value of this compound proposition, is true. Third one, negation P or R implies negation Q. So let us see. So negation P is false or R. R is also false, implies negation of Q. Q is true. Okay. So negation, first solve what is in the bracket. This is F or F, that is in or. Or false and false is false. So this will give you false, implies negation of true is false. Negation of false is true. True implies false. So just see in implies, true false will be false. So true false, answer is false. Okay, so it is, the compound proposition is having the truth value false. Let us see the fourth one now. P and Q or negation R. So for P, we have the truth value false. And Q is having true or negation false. Okay, so it is and now. And is true when both are true. but in this case it is false, or negation of false is true. Now this is or, so false and true. So you can see there in or, if it is false, false, it is false. Remaining all cases it is true. So this case answer will be true. So the truth value of this compound proposition is true. Fourth problem, if the compound proposition negation P implies Q and P and R is true, then find the truth values of P, Q and R. So this is like the reverse of the previous problem. So in the previous problem, the truth values of P, Q, R was given. You were supposed to find the truth value of the compound proposition. But now in this problem, the truth value of the compound proposition is given. This full proposition is true. You have to find out what are the individual truth values of P, Q and R. So let us see how to do this. So we have, so they have given negation P implies Q and P and R. So this is true. So observe here, this is connected with and, first part and second part. So when is and true? And is true only if both are true. So this part has to be true. Also this part, that is P and R, this also has to be true. Only then this will be true. Now look at this separately. Negation of which truth value will be true? Negation of what will be true? Negation of false will be true. So P implies Q has to be false. Did you get it? P implies Q has to be false, because only then negation of false is true. Now P implies Q is false. So under implication, if then, when is this false? First one should be true, second one should be false. So first one should be true and second one should be false. So P should be true, Q should be false. Only then P implies Q will be true. So we have found out the truth value of P. We have found out the truth value of Q. Now it remains to find out the truth value of R. So look at this now. It is and P and R is true. When will and be true? If both are true. So P is also true, R is also true. So P is true, we have already got. R is true is what we have found out. So P is true, Q is false and R is true. Next question. If the compound proposition P implies negation Q or R is false, then find the truth values of P, Q and R. So it is given that the compound proposition P implies negation Q or R is false. This is false now. Okay. So see here, it is implication, conditional. If P then Q, that type. So P implies this. When will that be false? When will conditional be false? It is false if the first part is true and second part is false. So this has to be true. P has to be true and this part has to be false. So negation of Q or R, this is false. Now observe here. It is or. Okay, or. When will or be false? Or is false. Or is false only if both are false. So negation of Q is also false and here R also should be false. So you will get R is equal to false. Now negation of what is false? Definitely negation of truth is false. Correct? Negation of true is false. Therefore Q has to be true. So we have found out the truth values of P, Q and R. P is true, Q is true and R is false. Fifth problem. If P is cube root of 3 is an integer, Q 2 is an odd number, R 5 is a prime number, then what is the truth value of P if and only if Q and R? So they have not given you directly the truth value of P, Q and R. Instead, they have given you the propositions. You have to decide whether it is true or false. So read the proposition P. What do you feel? Cube root of 3 is an integer. Is cube root of 3 an integer? No. So the truth value of P is false. P is false. What about Q? What about Q? 2 is an odd number. Is 2 an odd number? No, 2 is even. So this is also false. Let us see what is R. 5 is a prime number. It is true. 5 is prime. That is true. So now you have the truth tables of P, Q, R. Now let us find out the truth value of that proposition. So it is P if and only if Q and R. So P is false. False if and only if false and true. So what will this be? False if and only if false. Under biconditional, true, true is true. False, false is also true. So this is true and true. So and both true and true means it is true. So the truth value of the proposition is true. Sixth question. Construct the truth table of the following. So there is a proposition which is given. We need to construct the truth table for that. So here, observe first, there are only two simple propositions, that is P and Q. So when there are only two simple propositions P and Q, you will have four cases. That is true. So how do you write it? True, true, false, false, true, false, true, false. So this covers all the cases. Both true, true, false, false, true, both false. Okay, so how do we construct? We need to know what is the truth table of this in all the cases. So observe here, we need negation P. So write negation P. Then we need negation Q. So write negation Q. Then negation P and negation Q, we are connecting with AND. So negation P and negation Q. Okay, now to fill this column negation P, look at the column P. When P is true, what is its negation? True, negation is false. True, negation is false. False, negation is true. False, negation is true. Negation Q, so we have to negate this column now. When Q is true, negation is false. False, negation is true. True, negation is false. False, negation is true. Now we have negation P and negation Q. So these two columns we have to combine with AND. Okay? So whenever it is AND, remember, only if both are true, then the answer is true. Remaining all cases it is false. So search for both true. Okay, here both are true, so it is true. Remaining all cases, it is false. So this is how you construct the truth table. So let us see the second one now. P or Q and negation P. So there are only two simple propositions involved, that is P and Q. So write P, write Q. Now you need negation P, so write negation P. After that, you want P or Q. Then P or Q and negation P, you have to combine with AND. So P or Q and negation P. Okay, so this is the same, only four cases. Negation P, so negate this full column. True, negation is false. True, so false. False, true, false, true. P or Q, so P or Q. For these two columns, you have to apply OR. Okay, what about OR? When both are false, it is false. When it is OR, both false is false, remaining all cases true. Okay, now P or Q is this column and negation P is this column. So for these two columns you have to apply AND. For these two columns you have to apply AND. So when is AND true? How to remember for AND? AND is true when both are true. So search for both true. Both are true here, so this will be true. Remaining all cases it will be false. So this is how you construct the truth table for this. Next question, construct the truth table for this compound proposition. So observe here, there are three simple propositions, that is P, Q and R. So when there are three simple propositions, how to go about? You will have P, Q and R. So you have to combine all the possible cases, true, false, true, 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 false, true, true, false, 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 all cases you have to check. So how do we do that? Okay, so for that there is an easy way of writing. In the first column you write 4 truth and then 4 false. In the second column, true, true, false, false, true, true, false, false. And in the last one, single, true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. So this covers all the 8 possibilities, okay? So PQR with true and false, you can have 8 possibilities only. So all the 8 possibilities are covered here. Now look at the given proposition, okay? See what you want. You want negation of R. So find out what is negation R. Okay, what is negation R? True means false, false means true, true false, false true, true false, false true, true false, false true. Now Q and negation R, okay, Q and negation R. So combine this Q column with negation R with the connective AND. So remember for AND, both true means true, remaining all cases false. So search for true, true. This is true, false. So false, true, true. See here, Q is true, negation R is true. Here it will be true. Here false, false, true, false. True, false will be false. True, true. Observe here, Q is true, negation R is true, and. So true and true is true. False, false is false. False, true is also false. Now this we got, this much is completed. Now we want P or this term, okay? So P or Q and negation R. So Q and negation R, the column is here, P column is here. You have to connect these two columns with the connective OR. What do you remember about OR? It is false if both are false. Otherwise, everywhere it is true. So in these two columns, search for both false. This is true, false, true, true. Search for both false. Here it is both false. False and false. So it will be false. False and false will be false. False and false will be false. Remaining all cases, it is true. Observe here. P column and this column with the connective OR. So false, false is false. False, false is false. False, false is false. Remaining all cases it is true. So true, 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 true. So this is how you construct the truth table when you have three cases, that is P, Q and R. Three simple propositions. Next problem. P implies Q implies negation R. So how do we write the truth table for this? Observe, there are three simple propositions, P, Q and R. So it will go like this. So P, Q, R is there. You need all the cases. So write 4 true, 4 false. Then 2 true, 2 false. True, true, false, false. Then it is true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. Now observe the proposition. What do you need? You need negation R, so find out negation R. So it will become false, true, false, true, false, true, false, true. Then observe your bracket, you need P implies Q. So P implies Q. So in conditional, what you have to remember is, if it is true, first one is true and second one is false, then the answer is false. Remaining all cases, it is true. So under implication, remember when you have implication, true, false will be false. So P implies Q. So look at these two columns, okay? So second one should be false. See here, true, false. True, false is false. True, false is false. Again here, true, false, false. Okay, then we don't have here, all four are false, so that won't be there. So remaining all cases true. Remaining all cases true. Okay, so now this we have found out. We have negation R. We have to combine both of them with conditional. So P implies Q implies negation R. Okay, so you have to now combine this and this column with conditional. So conditional, remember, true, false, false. Remaining all cases true. So search for true, false. This is okay. First it is P implies Q, so true and then false. So here you have to search for true. True, false is false. True, true is true. True, false is false. True, false is false. Okay, remaining all cases true. So carefully observe, just because your negation R column is first, don't search for true false like this, okay? It is this first, P implies Q is first. So in this column, true should be there. Negation R column, false should be there. So true here, false here will give you false. Remaining all cases, it is true. Now we shall be studying about tautology and contradiction. What is this tautology and contradiction? So just now you have solved some problems. You have constructed the truth table. So the last column that you have obtained, no? In that column, fully if you get true, 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 full column true, then that is called tautology. If the last column, fully if it is false, then it is contradiction. Okay? Now read the definition. A compound proposition is said to be a tautology if it is true for all possible combinations of the truth values of its components. Okay, it should be true for all possible combinations. So that's why we write the full truth table with all possible combinations, and last column, if we obtain fully true, then it is a tautology. Fully false, then it is contradiction. So let us see one example for tautology. Here, if you observe, only P and Q, two simple propositions are involved. So all possible combinations are like this, true, true, false, false. Then you write true, false, true, false. So all four possibilities are combined here. Next, what do you need? You need P implies Q. So remember, when you have P implies Q, true, false is false. True, false is false. Remaining all cases, it is true. This is over. Come to this bracket, you need negation P. So negation P is true means false, true so false, false true, false true. Now combine negation P or Q. Negation P or Q. So this first, negation P or Q. So or is false when both are false. So both should be false, then it is false. That is negation P or Q. Both false means false, otherwise true. Now, combine P implies Q, this column with this column with the biconditional. So I will give the name as 1 here. I will give the name as 2 here. So 1 biconditional 2. So instead of writing this, the column, you need more space. So in order to consume less space, what you can do is you can give the column some other name like 1, 2 or A, B, X, Y, anything, and then you write it accordingly. Now biconditional, do you remember? It is true, true means true, false, false means also true. Remaining two cases it is false. So search here, this and this column, both true means true, both false means also true, both true is true, both true is true. See here, the final column that you get is fully filled with true. True, 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 true for all possible combination of the truth values of its components. Therefore, this is an example for tautology. We shall now see contradiction. So, we shall now see what is contradiction. So, as I already told you, a compound proposition is called a contradiction if it is false, okay, the entire column should be false for all possible combinations of truth values of its components. If you observe this example, you have components only P and Q. So I'm considering P and Q, true, true, false, false, true, false. Now I need P and Q, and if both are true, it is true, remaining all cases it is false. Then I need P or Q, or when I have it is false, when both are false, remaining all cases it is true. Then I have negation of that, so negation of P or Q. So negation of this will be false, false, false and true. Finally I have AND connecting this column and this column. So it is 1 and 2. This column, that is P and Q, I am calling it as 1. This column, I am calling it as 2, so it is 1 and 2. So in these two columns, AND means it is true if both are true. So both true means true, otherwise it is false. Both true is not there at all, so all cases is false. So you can see here, the last answer that you get is all false, therefore this is a contradiction. Let us now solve some problems. Prove that P implies Q and Q implies R implies P implies R is a tautology. So observe here, P, Q, R, three simple propositions are involved. So you will have 8 cases. True, 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 true. False, 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 false. Then you have true, true, false, false, true, true, false, false, true, false, true, false, true, false, true, false. Okay, now observe what you want. You want P implies Q, so P implies Q. P implies Q is false if first is false, first is true, second is false. True, false, search for true, false in these two columns. True, false is false. True, false is false. Remaining all cases, it is true. Okay. Then you want Q implies R. Q implies R. So now observe these two columns, Q and R. True, false will be false. So true, false is false. True, false is false. Remaining all cases true. So you have to combine this with AND. So P implies Q and Q implies R. So I will call this as 1 and I will call this as 2. So I am connecting 1 with AND, with 2. Okay. Now with these two columns, AND. Okay. AND is true when both are true. True, true, true. Both are true, so true. Both true, so true, both true, true. Remaining all cases, it is false. Okay, next observe here, you have P implies R. So find out what is P implies R. P and R, so first column and third column, check for true, false. You have true here, you have false here, so it is false. True, false, so it is false. Then everything will be true. Okay. So now look at the question. So this full thing, we have it here, this column 1 and 2. So let me call this as column A now. This full column, I'm calling it as column A. This column, I will call it as column B. So now I have to, you know, combine column A under conditional symbol with column B. So A conditional B. If it is true, false, then false, remaining all cases true. I'm searching for true, false. Okay, here it is true. There is no true, false. Okay, if there was true, false, then it would be false. So these are all remaining other cases where everything will be true. So we have proved that this is a tautology. So we have proved that this compound proposition is a tautology. Second problem, show that negation P and Q and Q and R and negation Q is a contradiction. So if you observe, there are three simple propositions involved, P, Q and R. So write the truth table. So four truths and four false. Then true, true, false, false, true, true, false, false. Then you have true, false, true, false, true, false, and true, false. So observe here, negation P and Q. So you need negation P. So negate the column P. False, 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 true, 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 true. Next, negation P and Q. So negation P, you have to combine with this Q column and connect it with AND. So you know that in AND, if both are true, it is true. Search for both true. Here, this is true. Remaining all cases, false. Next, Q and R. So Q is here, R is here, connect it with AND. So AND means both should be true if it has to be true. Remaining all cases false. Then we need negation Q. So negate the column Q. So you will have false, false, true, true, false, false, true, true. Now, negation P and Q, that column is here, I will call it as 1. And you have to combine it with AND with the Q and R, this column. So this and this, so 1 and 2. Okay, this is combined with this, with the connective AND. This part we will see later. So 1 and 2, so this column, these two columns connected with AND. AND means both should be true, if it has to be true. Remaining all cases false. Now, this much is in this column. I will call it as column A. With negation Q, you have to connect it with AND. So this is column B. So A, full thing is A and B. So look at A and B. Both should be true if it has to be true, otherwise false. So you cannot see a true here, both cases true, everything is the other cases, so everything is false. So observe here, the last column, that is your proposition, the given compound proposition is completely false in all the cases, so this is a contradiction. Third question, check whether P and negation Q implies P and Q is a tautology or contradiction. So let us see. They have not asked prove that it is tautology or show that it is a contradiction. They are asking you to check. Okay, let us check. So here, if you observe in the compound proposition, there are only two simple propositions involved, that is P and Q. Okay, so true, true, false, false. True, false, true, false. This will cover all the four possibilities. So we need negation Q. So negation Q will be false, true, false, true. Now combine it with AND, P and negation Q. So P and negation Q. So when it is and, both have to be true. If it should be true, otherwise it is false. Then you have P and Q. P and Q. So both should be true. If it should be true, otherwise it is false. Now with the conditional, you have, let me call this as 1, let me call this as 2. Then it will be 1 conditional 2. Okay, so whenever you have conditional, that is if then, true false will be false. So search for true false. True false will be false. Remaining cases it will be true. Observe here, it is not fully true, it is not fully false. It is a mixture of true and false. Therefore, this is neither tautology nor contradiction. Therefore, given proposition is neither tautology nor contradiction. It is neither tautology nor contradiction. Thank you, students. That's all in this session.